Let's talk about Swalwell, because you have not had the briefing that I had. I had the briefing and Nancy Pelosi had the briefing from the FBI. The FBI never came before this Congress to tell the leadership of this Congress that Eric Swalwell had a problem with a Chinese spy until he served on Intel. So it wasn't just us who were concerned about it. The FBI was concerned about putting a member of Congress on the Intel committee that has the rights to see things that others don't because of his knowledge and relationship with a Chinese spy. They brought it to the works of the leaders. I've got that briefing. So I do not believe he should sit on there.
Yeah, no, he doesn't believe any of what he just said. He's not a particularly bright person. Very few of them actually are, but he's smart enough to know that the stuff about the Chinese spy is ancient, debunked nonsense that only the dumbest, most naive right-wingers online care at all about. It means nothing. And by the way, if it existed, if it was damning, again, I don't give much of an anything about Eric Swalwell. If it turned out that he was super corrupt and all that, I think we've proven we're perfectly comfortable criticizing or even attacking the Democrats. But this is nonsense. And again, if you are in the business of trying to provide actual fact-based, reality-based oversight, actually criticizing people where they need to be criticized, it should annoy you to no end when nonsense is used to attack people. Because again, when you train people to look at politics through the lens of madness, of conspiracism, then how are you ever going to get them to pay attention to reality? To look at, like we say constantly, you know, follow the money and everything, follow the actual money, the fact-based. But if people will believe whatever they read on a forum or whatever, then you cannot make an actual fact-based, reality-based case. And that is more annoying than almost anything else in politics these days. The spy stuff is absolute nonsense. He responded with that. Of course, it doesn't matter. It's not going to give him back on the committee. But Swalwell tweeted, this rejection is based on a claim that the Washington Post independent fact checker gave four Pinocchios. Speaker Boehner and Ryan, both Gang of Eight members, appointed me to Intel with access to the same facts McCarthy is distorting. He can keep me off Intel, but I'm not going away. Again, like it is not impossible that someone on the Washington Post could run cover for an establishment Democrat. Sure, they could. But again, he's pointing out this is so ancient that many of you watching probably don't even remember when Boehner and Ryan were notable Republicans. That's how ancient this stuff is. But now it's so pressing that Swalwell immediately has to be booted off. It has nothing to do with the fact that Kevin McCarthy's future is now in the hands of Marjorie Greene and people like her. So anyway, those are the two that are off. He's also expected to hold a floor vote on kicking Representative Ilhan Omar off the Foreign Affairs Committee for the crime of being Muslim. Let's be clear about that. Though that could face opposition from his own party. Representatives Nancy Mace and Victoria Spartz have both said they oppose kicking Democrats off their committees. I don't know too much about Victoria Spartz. Nancy Mace, this is apparently an actual principled position. Nancy Mace is the worst. She has said some truly reprehensible things, particularly about Representative Ocasio-Cortez in the wake of the insurrection. But here she is being at least something like principled, JR. So that's good to see.
Yeah, Nancy Mace does that from time to time. She also has some points when they were talking about the debate over McCarthy, and she's talking about Roe v. Wade, and she's very much pro-life, she says, but she also has many exceptions. So she's somewhere in the middle on certain issues, and she's very vocal about those things, so people won't really pay attention to the things that she's is about, which is 98% of every other Republican. But they're there. You talked about Kevin McCarthy and how he's not beholden to Marjorie Taylor Greene. Also the fact that he did point out and say openly that he says, I will never leave that woman. I will always take care of her. Does that sound like a leader that's looking to do something legislatively or something for the country? I will never leave that woman. I will always take care of her. I'm sure your constituents would love to hear you say that about them. Instead, it's about her, because this is about your political power. And now she was a big assist and broke with her normal gang of crazy to help you get that position. So now that you're there, you owe her. This is the position that the Speaker of the House is in. And he also owes the rest of the crazies. This is the reason why he got rid of Swalwell and Schiff. And he hopes that Donald Trump is sitting there from Mar-a-Lago nodding going, good job, yeah. Kip, good job.
Yeah, it's such an embarrassing thing to have to say, and such a weird way to put it if you are gonna say it. I don't want to think any more about why he worded it that way. But again, like, this is, he's experiencing something of what people like Ted Cruz and others have experienced, where like they're coming up and they're thinking, I'm gonna be such hot whatever, I'm so smart, I got this whole thing locked down. It's probably gonna be perfectly fine if I chain my wagon to craziness. That's not gonna bite me on the ass at all. And now he has to do basically whatever Marjorie Greene wants. Like, that's why he's doing this. In any event, good on Sparts, good on Mace. We'll see if they actually come through for it. But let's be very clear, if it wasn't clear enough, again, with Ilhan Omar, this is just giving Fox News and the right wing base what they want. How dare this woman have been a migrant, a refugee? How dare she be a Muslim? How dare she be strong and outspoken? We're gonna take her down. By the way, the people who are going to say that she necessarily has to be taken off the committee are the same people that thought that Marjorie Greene, whatever her comments were about space lasers, about putting a bullet in Pelosi's head, they didn't think that justified taking her off of any committees. Let's be clear, 8 Republicans voted for her to be stripped from her committee, which means that well over 100 didn't. But they do think that whatever it is that Ilhan Omar said is going to be all the justification necessary. So look forward to for that in the near future. For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.